Me, Ivo, seriously, my fingers are the only part of me that is getting any action in this war with the deep state. My whole body wants to push back, to fight, to go and start my own community, to move, to leave where I am, and yet it's my fingers that get all the work as a keyboard warrior. The solution to changing the outer is to change the inner. But that doesn't demand any action, and I feel like acting. I'm not terribly affected by what's going on this earth, but I feel for places like Victoria, Australia, because they are at level 4 lockdown and the police are coming around door to door to ensure compliance. Sounds like Kristallnacht in Germany when they went door to door putting Stars of David on the doors that housed the Jews. Victoria is now sporting a communist Chinese flag on their police station. What the hell is going on down there? This is crazy. I have friends telling me what it's like, and I'll keep in touch to see when things will improve after our meditations. We are asking everyone to meditate for 10 or 15 minutes, with the intent of sending white light energy to Victoria to help relieve them of this lockdown. Or someone will come in to intervene to help the people. Seriously. What is going on there? I think we all have to be very careful what we bring upon ourselves, because we could all end up like that or worse. We have to remain steadfastly sure in our minds that we are safe and it will not happen to us. What is keeping the virus counts low in Canada? We are. Our minds are what fight disease. Louise Hay proved that a long time ago when she wrote her book You Can Heal Your Life. Ivo, I want to have a conversation to show everyone listening now that they are strong and their mind has more influence on their life than anyone has ever let onto them. We need to teach them now how powerful they are. Ivo, my love, this is a very good idea. Your people need to know this now. Me, the first thing I want to ask people listening, did you ever get what you asked for? You wanted something and you got it? You, probably like me, as a child asked for a toy, maybe a Barbie doll, and there she was as she showed up at your next birthday or under the Christmas tree, that Pleiadian looking diva with long blonde hair that I used to look at as if she were strangely familiar to me. So you learned that getting what you want was a question of asking. Well, it is. But now instead of asking your mother for a Barbie, you ask God to help work with you. And know that if it's in your best interests, you'll get it. Today I refused a book deal that would have paid me thousands of dollars in royalties because the payment schedule didn't suit me. I was a bit miffed at the thought of this being whisked away when Ivo said, there will be better deals. Do not worry. I had been fixated on how I could earn $500 extra this month, and when this deal came up the proposer said he could issue me a €500 advance in anticipation of future sales. I thought, that's it? That's my $500. Well, close. Then Ivo said, was it 500, exactly? I said, no, and he noted that I wasn't getting what I'd asked for. I asked for 500 and this was more. I thought that's not bad, but he said it wasn't what I asked for. The deal doesn't work for me, so I dropped negotiations, expecting something better to come along. I would like to go through some examples of things I've asked for and they just suddenly appeared. I have this telepathy going with my neighbor and he answers my questions without my asking them of him. It's happened 3 times already now and I just make note of when he does it and have a snicker. I couldn't remember his oldest boy's name, and then one day he called him and I answered, yeah, what's up, and he said, no, Darren. My boy. And he reminded me his boy's name is very similar to mine. And he asked me for toilet paper the other day, as I knew they'd run out, and asked to have some of mine. I knew it was coming. You get what you ask for. If it's a lot of crap, then you have to change your thinking. Think better for yourself. Affirmations help too, because I find they help change a negative mind. When I was working, I used to say there were 2 places I'd never work, legal firms and accountancies, because I thought being there would be so boring. I ended up getting a day job, guess where? In an accountancy. And as I realized that I needed more money, I looked for a second job on afternoon shift, and guess where I ended up? In the typing pool of a legal firm. When you get what you don't want, it's because of your frequency. I drive a Kia Rio now. It's 3.5 years old. It's never given me one problem, ever. It's the best car. It looks cute and it drives excellently. I used to look at my ex-boss wife's car and thought it would be a good one for me. She had a Rio. I didn't have the money to buy one and I didn't want a car loan, so I waited till I got enough money to pay cash for the car. I got that money when my mother died quite a bit later, but I got the money to pay cash for a brand new car. I got what I wanted. I was tired of driving old junkers and I wanted the car paid for when I drove it off the lot. I got what I wanted. You can too. You just have to know, be absolutely certain that God is good and has your good in mind. Ivo, you are beings of limitation. You have learned limitation and to think of lack as a daily way of life. This is not at all your truth, not even close. You are beings who are part of God, you are creators within yourselves, and so you can create whatever lack or abundance you choose. Many of you create lack because you believe in what your world tells you. That if you do not have a college education, you will never make much money. That is nonsense. Look at people who make a living at selling. They do not have any special education, but they can sell. If they sell large expensive items like homes, they will make a lot of money doing it. The larger the city they live in, the more they will earn. Me, true. Ivo, you must learn to think beyond the rules. You see that now young people are not inclined to want to be mortgaged all their lives, so they think up alternative living situations, such as tiny homes and living in trailers welded together. They do not have a mortgage. They also do not have much space, but they must set their priorities. They are thinking beyond the financial system that has been put in place to keep you in debt and depressed about it. If you are earning minimum wage, and you want to earn more money, ask yourself now how you can double or triple your income. Without saving and scrimping, how can you earn more? Me, I thought of putting my photography up for sale. I have artwork and have been doing paint pours lately, and I also can design t-shirts and put them up on websites that will print to order. I could do car stickers too, and I know what I would do them about. The New World Order, just like the two that are on back of my Kia. I got them from Zazzle. Just think how little effort it took to design them because they're just print, but I value their message. I was thinking of doing up implant communications t-shirts so you could buy our pictures and wear them. Or even posters if people still put them up on walls, I don't know. All ideas I could look into as side gigs and link them up to my website someday. Ivo, correct. And this deal that fell through could also show you the potential our books have to bring in more income. Nothing, as you realize, is ever lost on you. You worked with an old man in Toronto, learning how to work in book distribution and sales. It cost you your own savings at the time, but look to see how it is coming in handy now. You have industry knowledge. Me, true. I don't find anything I've ever learned was for nothing. Even studying languages has come in handy since my books are sold around the world. Ivo, so, for the current situation, you must all use your powerful minds, whether you believe they are powerful or not, it does not matter. Know they are powerful, and that you must use them to attract better circumstances for yourself, and do not fear because fear will attract worse circumstances for yourself. Do not focus on what you do not want, focus on what you do want. Fear will make you focus on what you do not want. You attract your lessons. Also, use your mind to help out others, to strengthen their minds, such as the people in Victoria, Australia, to help fight the deep state. What is happening there as well as across the earth is a battle of your minds versus the minds of the deep state players, which, because they are dependent upon you for their survival, are considerably weaker than your minds are. You are part of the Godhead, and have the strongest minds. Use them to fight these weaker minds into submission. The deep state players have positioned themselves as your leaders only in the physical. That is because you are the leaders in the non-physical, so use your mind to change the outcome in Earth's favor. Be focused in your intention that you will not come to harm, and to help others around the world be released from harm as well. Sheran has manifested so much in her life. She manifested going on disability in her early 40s. Originally she wanted just 6 months off of work, but as her kundalini awoke and she started to clear out blockages, she realized that she could not work in corporate environments anymore. Yes, and this was after September 11th as it was for so many people. It was 2001. It was a time of great change for many. Sheran's activation started then in earnest. By the end of 2002, she was on long-term disability. Me, geez, I didn't even think of that. It was at 9/11. Same with my cousin. She quit her job too. Now she fights for animals' rights. Ivo, work with the incoming energies to strengthen the love on Earth. Bring it in and apply healing light to areas that require it most. Right now is Lebanon and Victoria. There are other areas that have suffered cabal attack. Work with these if you wish, but your fine, powerful minds are required now. Understand, manifestation is happening now much more quickly than ever before. Your frequency is speeding up and manifestation happens more quickly. Me, so I'll still attract $500 this month? Ivo, the month is not yet over, my love. Me, I want it so I can prep. I'm stockpiling as much as I can, and here in Canada things are still not so bad. The shelves are stocked pretty well. There's loads of toilet paper and no limits. I don't know if they're allowing cross-border shopping, but if they do, Americans could get some paper. My thinking has really changed from looking at extras and non-essentials to stocking essentials right now. Ivo, as it should. And saving money. You are doing well there as well. Me, yup. I am. Ivo, we would like all listening now to stop limiting yourself by your paycheck. If you believe that you cannot earn more than $14 per hour, challenge yourself to figure out how to earn $30 per hour. Can you do extra jobs, help others with home renovations? Paint someone's home? Fix someone's car? Do lawn care for neighbors, which might be nice if you have an indoor job, to work outside on weekends? Can you take in children for babysitting? Challenge yourself to earn more. Challenge yourself to meditate and send energy to needy places upon earth. Challenge yourself to leave the matrix and its limiting mindset behind. Ask, what if? Ask yourself, what if I could earn an extra couple thousand to go on a wonderful vacation this winter? Ask yourself, what if I could work on opening my third eye and meet my ET team? Challenge yourself to go beyond what you believe is possible. You know that it is impossible to catch COVID if you believe you cannot. When you do not fear it, you cannot catch it. People will laugh and say you are crazy, but it is they that do not understand how the human works. Me, I can think of quite a few things I pulled off that would be considered illegal. I don't care. I don't answer to their law, I answer to universal law. And that's what you have to work with in order to manifest. Believe it. Achieve it. Ivo, this is true, my love. There are two systems running concurrently. Which do you wish to be with? Your matrix system or God's system of universal love and law? Me, thank you, Ivo. Ivo, my love, do not worry about the deal. Me, I'm over it. I don't take unnecessary risks and I'm becoming more insistent that I get my needs met. Getting 6% on all paperback book sales is crap. While they get 94%. It's like they own the book, not me, at that percentage. I can print off my own books and sell them. Nothing to stop me from calling places and ask if they want a shipment sent. I've already done that before. Ivo, exactly. You need not rely upon them for your well-being. Their rates are too low. You can also approach other print-as-you-go vendors for deals with them. Me, yeah, there's lots of them. Thank you, Ivo.